Hello and welcome back to Norty's Forgotten Flicks. And with the sequel coming out in a few months, I figure it's finally time to do one on Now You See Me. Yes, but it's my show, I can do whatever I want. No, I'm not. Shut up. Released in late May 2013, Now You See Me was directed by Louis Leterrier, who you may remember directing The Incredible Hulk, Clash of the Titans, and the first two Transporter films. And it was written by Men in Black / Bill & Ted alumni Ed Solomon, Remember the Titans director Boaz Yakin, and Edward Reichert, who wrote one episode of Jessica Jones. It follows four magicians who have been summoned via tarot cards for a special mission by an anonymous mystery man. The four are street magician Danny Atlas, played by Jesse Eisenberg, Merritt McKinney, a psychic, played by Woody Harrelson, Henley Reeves, an escape artist, played by Isla Fisher, and Jack Wilder, an illusionist / pickpocket, played by Dave Franco. A year later, the four are putting on a show in Las Vegas as a group called the Four Horsemen, and they call upon a volunteer to help them rob a bank. Through, well, magic, they transport him to a bank in France and manage to transport all the money back to Las Vegas. And because, well, they're basically criminals, they're being followed by FBI agent Dylan Rhodes, played by Mark Ruffalo. Oh, and Michael Caine and Morgan Freeman are also in there, but their parts get into spoiler territory, so you'll just have to see the movie to see what they do. So based on that description, I bet you think this movie sounds really, really stupid. And I wouldn't use the word stupid, I think a better word would be crazy. It's a crazy ride, and I love it. The best thing I can say for this movie is that it feels like a magic trick. Something unexpected that leaves you wondering, how did they do that? Every 10 minutes or so, they are throwing some twist in your face. When you think you finally have figured the movie out, they throw something else at you to let you know that you're at least 3 steps behind. And it all kind of makes sense when they reveal the trick. No cop-outs, every trick they do, you're like, yeah, that actually kind of makes sense. And that is because it is directed, shot, and edited in a way that makes you feel like you're watching a real magic show. You see nothing more than what the audience sees until after the trick has been pulled off. I love that. It honestly did give me that sense of wonder again. Even though you know deep down it's fake, the mastery of deception tricks you into believing it's real.
It's 11:50 p.m. here in Vegas. That's 8:50 a.m. in Paris. Your bank opens in less than 10 minutes. One, two,
three.
What the fuck?
And if it wasn't directed and edited in that way, then this movie would have completely fallen flat. But sleight of hands is one thing. What about everything else? The four main actors playing the horsemen are really good, and they work really well off each other. Eisenberg is the awkward wise-ass, Fisher is a show-off, Harrelson is the cocky one, and Franco is the whiny, inexperienced one. But despite that, the actors are just so likable, and since they're helping out the 99%, you forgive most of their flaws. Also, despite not being an action movie, there are a few action scenes in it, and they are actually pretty entertaining. There's a chase scene through New Orleans. A fight scene in an apartment. And a car chase through New York.
Go, 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 go.
All of them are better directed and edited than some action movies I've seen. The effects worth, especially in the magic acts, is simple but effective. Also, it's pretty funny. While it for the most part wasn't trying to be a comedy, there are quite a few good one-liners in there.
So you're gonna have to stop masturbating. He says why? He says so I can finish the examination.
And now you will say the magic words.
Abracadabra.
Yes, and I will wave this magic wand for no reason.
I feel like I'm playing with somebody wearing ankle weights. Lippers. Keep up, Agent Rhodes. Keep up.
There's not much in terms of flaws, at least if you're looking for an entertaining summer thriller. But there is one final twist that may seem like one twist too many. It's not so much bad, when you look back you say, I guess that kind of made sense, but it's so out of nowhere, so what the fuck, and so makes you have to buy a lot of far-fetched shit that it can take you out of the movie. However, I don't mind it too much. Now some of you may be thinking, Wait a minute, didn't you complain about the ending of The Prestige for that exact same reason? And that's true. While I did enjoy most of The Prestige, I found the ending to be way too out of nowhere and felt tacked on just to make the movie seem smarter than it really was. But the difference is, Now You See Me doesn't take itself seriously. It knows it's over the top and just wants to have fun with its premise. Well, The Prestige was much, much more serious. So basically, The Prestige is like Harry Houdini, while Now You See Me is like Siegfried and Roy. Now my favorite scene is a bit of a spoiler, more of a plot point, but if you want to skip it, go here in the video. Now the scene is right at the end of their second show when the Four Horsemen call several people and ask them what they have in their bank accounts. And then they call Michael Caine's character Trezler with a check showing how much is in his bank account.
Now Hart, I took a guess. North of 140, am I right? That's 140 million, by the way. Now, everybody take out your paper and using the flashlight under your seat, start to warm up that paper. I think your correct balance begins to appear. Whoa! Huh. What's going on there, Daniel?
This is weird. A second ago it said 144,579,651, but now it says $70,000 less.
Well, hey, check it out. It's happening again.
Is it?
Wow. It is. Art's balance has gone down another 280K.
Gina Robertson, what did yours say?
$281,477.
We have a confession to make.
We lied about something.
Yes, none of you were chosen at random.
All of you have one thing in common.
Everyone in this room was a victim of the hard times that hit one of America's most treasured cities.
Some of you lost your houses, your cars,
your businesses,
your loved ones. But all of you were insured by the same company.
Trezler Insurance.
You were abandoned.
You were loopholed.
Out of your settlements.
This is all for show, correct?
Oh, meaning we're doing it on stage in front of a paying audience? Then yes, it's for show.
I've got $82,000 on my bank account. It says it right here on my cell phone. Everybody look at your cell phones right now. Everybody.
I can't help it, I just love watching rich assholes get their money stolen from them. That's why we all love Robin Hood. Now yes, this movie technically did make a lot of money, hell, it's getting a sequel, and it beat out Will Smith's After Earth at the box office. And while it wasn't panned, I feel most people see it as just fine. I personally think it's better than that. I think they tried harder than they could have, given that it was probably going to make its money back based off the cast. And it's a bit smarter than most people gave it credit for. Is it perfect? No. And at the end of the day, it is mostly meant for entertainment. But if you want to see it, you may find a little more than just mindless fun in this silly little movie. So check it out. And before you ask, yes, I am looking forward to the sequel. Well, it is a shame they lost Fisher. They at least replaced her with Lizzie Kaplan and Daniel Radcliffe. So that's nice.
Ta-da!
So, thank you all for watching. And remember, the closer you look, the less you actually see.